I own the stock, but I've got to tell you, GE Capital is an anchor dragging this stock down. I mean, I value GE in, as the sum of its parts, and when I value GE Capital, the value that I assigned to GE Capital was about minus 16 to minus 20 billion. In other words, it's reducing the value of GE by $16 to $20 billion. If somebody walked up to GE and said, we'll take GE Capital off your hands for nothing, that'll be a great bargain. So I think if the key for GE is it has to navigate the GE Capital exit, and that's not going to be easy because it's embedded in every one of their other businesses. Because if you look at their aviation business, their power business, GE Capital is embedded in those businesses. So it's so difficult for GE to extricate itself from those businesses. But if you look at its businesses themselves, it has three very good businesses, which if you take the aviation business as its prime, three very average businesses in power and one horrible business, which is GE Capital. But overall, if you look at the collection of businesses, I think it is a buy, but it's a buy that will require a strong stomach for the next 6 months, maybe a year, while GE Capital continues to give it trouble.
Yeah, it's a buy on some of the parts, but a lot of people say it's not necessarily on the ability to generate cash flow and or deal with, of course, a significant debt level.
Yeah, and that's, I think, my concern, is that debt has to be navigated. My feeling is it'll find a way to do it because it is enough valuable parts to be able to use to cover that debt, but it is a clear and present danger right now.